When you think of athletic trainers, you usually think of ice packs and tape. But at the University of Kentucky, a team of trainers is doing unique basic science research that could help athletes and non-athletes alike.
I started as an athlete and hurt myself, hurt my knee, became an athletic trainer and a clinician, and then in the clinic we see more muscle injuries than anything else. And from years of working as a clinician with dealing with muscle injury, I became interested in trying to study muscle injury.
When it came to going to get my master's, I really wanted to do a master's in athletic training specifically. And there's only about 14, maybe 15 schools in the nation that offer that particular degree, and UK was one of them.
Chris is a very, very motivated graduate student. And I think in part because she's an athletic trainer to start with. And athletic trainers are notorious for working long hours for low pay and a pat in the back every once in a while. So if you think about getting up at 4 a.m. and covering hockey practice, or getting up at 4 a.m. and writing a paper, I think she's finding a great deal more reward now in what she's doing, a quicker reward, and which still has that same work ethic that she always had before. And it makes it really good to work with her.
Tim Butterfield's team builds devices to exercise and massage muscle, then studies the effects on the cells. Only two devices exist, one here at UK and the other at Ohio State, where Butterfield was a postdoc, that specifically measure the effect of massage.
Well, I think it's important to measure scientifically because everybody wants a massage and people spend a lot of money on massage. And people also spend a lot of money on pharmacological interventions when people have pain. And if there's something that will help muscle adapt and heal and become better at performing its function, they're less expensive and easier to apply, then I think it's worth investigating.
Our cyclic compressive loading device is just a phenomenal tool for looking at massage. Because we know the stiffness of those springs, we're able to then calculate the amount of force that's being applied to the muscle in real time as it's fed back to our computer system. And so it's really unique because it allows us the opportunity to not only just look at how much force we're applying to the muscle, but it also allows us to even evaluate that. You know, what type of a force is too much? What's too little? What's the optimal force to be applied to get the response that we're looking for?
So if we can control all those variables and then pull out the cells and see how they respond, we have a better idea of what caused that cell to respond that way.
If we know the mechanism underlying what is happening at the cellular level, we can better tailor our treatment.
Chris Waters Banker is studying the inflammatory response, specifically the actions of neutrophils and macrophages. Neutrophils arrive first on site, and because they steal electrons from other cells, they can cause tissue damage.
In my research, potentially attenuating the neutrophilic response, not eliminating it, but somehow lessening the response, could potentially be beneficial. The macrophages, we know, they come in second, and they clean up the mess that the neutrophils have made to then participate in the rebuilding of the muscle itself. I don't by any means want to diminish the inflammatory response to the point where it's non-existent because I know how important it is for the rebuilding. But if I can apply a massage to create that transition potentially a little bit earlier than normal, then we can create a beneficial environment so that it can heal itself and go through all the appropriate stages that are necessary for that rebuilding process.
If we can find a way to reduce the bad inflammation, the things that cause tissue necrosis and tissue damage, and benefits of the good inflammation that causes repair, then that may be really helpful for us down the road.